Namaste and welcome to Tale of Inner Journey. Today we have with us a very beautiful person from a very diverse background and also a multidimensional background. And his journey is one of the most exciting and beautiful. From a small town growing up and traveling all over and creating so much awareness in people, educating people and helping them into stand on their own feet. He has done a tremendous amount of work, and it's so wonderful to welcome Sri S.V. Venkatesh. Thank you and welcome to our program, sir.
Thank you so much.
To start, just tell us a few little bit about your early part of your life, childhood, your background, a little bit.
I started my journey and in a Mysore. It was in Bhadravati. I have born and brought up in Bhadravati. I was there for 17 years. Then my father is come from near Mandya. He's called as Santebachalli. So that's why my name is being named as S.V. Venkatesh.
Okay.
So S stands for Santebachalli. V stands for Venkatramaya. So I'm a son of
Venkatramaya.
Then my mother, she has come from Chikmagalur.
Okay.
So I born brought up in Bhadravati because my father was working as one of the employee in Visheshwarayar Anastasia Vikapadravati. And that's how my small journey has started. And my sister, my younger brother, younger brother and my elder cousin brother also, we were all together. Bhadravati is a very, very small town. And we were all grown up very well, had many number of relatives and too many cousins, maybe 25-30 cousins and many friends. So that's how the journey has started. I started with a government school. My education started with a government school in Kannada medium. So that's how it has started. It's called as WHPS, Welfare Higher Primary School. So I started my education. So I was there. I studied up to 7th standard and then I moved to the another high school. So we did that, and I was good, but academically we are very, very strong. Means we used to score minimum 30 to 35 marks in every exam. So because our objective was very, very clear. We need to move to the next level.
That's it.
So that was the clear target, and my father used to say very clearly that don't stay in the same year.
Yeah, keep moving.
So other than that, there is nothing big headed. And we had, in fact, we were not taught or we were not exposed. We are not heard about what future is all about, how you should focus your lineup, what you should do after 20 years, what you stand from now, from next 5 years, 10 years. We were very clear. We were so eager. We were so focused. We were so stressed out on the next Sunday's cricket match. So we have to play with whom. So we were very, very clear about that.
Yes.
That is how we have done. We were celebrating every festival. We were enjoying it. And
yeah.
We had a huge amount of friends. And that is how we have born, brought up. And that is how my journey has started. Then I got into first year PUC because only one reason that, in fact, my academic, as I said, very strong. So 210 was a passing marks in SSLC. So my score was 212. So better to have at least two extra numbers to manage the GST if required. So that's how I started. But incidentally, my mathematics I was good at, and I scored 71. So my father thought that, okay, he may be one more Visheshwarayar in my family. So he put me onto the science. So first year PUC, I have lost only 5 subjects out of 6. Except Kannada.
Yes. Wow.
So that's how I started my journey at the beginning. Then I got into Diploma in Electronics and Communication. So I did my Diploma in Electronics and Communication in Shivamogga. And that is how, because that's how my journey of education started. And that's how I am so close to my Bhadravati for 17 years.
Wow.
I stayed 1 or 2 years in Shivamogga to complete my diploma.
Yeah. Bhadravati was very, even though the town was small, because of the iron ore industry attracted many people from many different walks of life. How did that influence you as you were growing up?
I always love to recognize myself as a more about Bhadravatiyan than Mysore, because Mysore, even though I have completed around 32 years staying in Mysore, no doubt I love too much about Mysore, but Bhadravati, my childhood was, honestly, it was very, very awesome. You know why? Because most of the sports, we tested most of the sports. Today, I doubt that kids are aware about polo, what we have tried. We have tried marathon of 11 kilometers and shot put throw, javelin throw.
Yeah.
And that was not a kind of a different sports for us. In fact, today, I doubt that many of them then even know about handball. We were playing handball. The Bhadravati, the biggest asset is that kind of a sports exposure we got tremendous.
Yeah.
Because there is all India's steel plant used to play. And in fact, the Bhadravati, we have witnessed the Ranji Trophy in Bhadravati.
Yeah.
It was a small town and the Ranji Trophy used to happen. So that's how our exposure towards the sports was very, very good.
That's fine.
And we had a good healthcare, good education, everything which was, and good influence which I had. But for me, as a personally, if I look at myself and go back, I have learned maximum from the scout and guides. Because when I was in the fourth standard, I still remember, because I joined the Cubs.
Yeah, Cubs. Yeah.
And the fifth standard, I become a vice captain. So when I become a vice captain, my father took me and gave me a masala dosa. Okay, I still remember, because that's something which is award.
Yeah, it's a,
and that's all we have enjoyed. And I started learning my leadership or anything which I have learned anything. I love to give more credit to my scouts, because I have learned most of my leadership qualities or whatever little I know.
Yes.
Thanks to the scouts and guides.
Such an amazing thing, because nowadays nobody's go towards the Cubs or scouts.
See, that is where exactly I realistically look at. That is how we are missing it out.
Yeah.
When I was fifth, I was in scout vice captain. Sixth, I was a captain. Seventh, I was a captain. Then I have to move out for a eighth standard. That's high school.
School change.
Then I changed the school. I started as a vice captain in an eighth for a scout. Then ninth standard, eighth standard, I attended a state jamboree. Ninth standard, I have attended the national jamboree in Bihar. And even though I was not good in English nor in Hindi, so we managed to go and participate in National Jamboree. In fact, I'm supposed to get a president medal. Because of the 10th standard, my father decided, okay, this fellow has to go to bank, for a further study. Otherwise, he'll not go to complete even SSLC.
Yeah.
So then I moved to SSLC, then I lost my scout.
But
scout has given me a lot of insight. That is right now, it is there in my kind of a DNA.
Yeah, exactly. Because that's where the, and the, these are the years that really molds us. Yeah.
It is true.
Yeah. Yeah. And growing up in a very large family, extended family, it's an advantage in a way, but also a disadvantage. But if you are ready for the challenges, because like there are, as you said, 25 cousins and your brothers and sisters, you have to prove yourself for survival in a way. Even though in a very affectionate world, there is no wildness or survival of the fittest, but you have to earn it. So that also teaches you quite a lot.
That is a kind of, honestly, it was very, very good. We never felt, you know, in fact, we used to fight every day and we used to enjoy every day and we used to connect every day. And that is one. Lot of learning take place when we were staying with 4-5 families together.
Yeah.
In fact, even now, that may be the one of the luckiest I am, because we have around 7-8 families who are all there in Bhadravati now, completely relocated in Mysore.
Wow.
And in 5 minutes, we all come together and every weekend we meet, irrespective of every weekend, and same discussion somehow. That is something which is re-energizing myself and disconnecting from the other world and getting into my family world. I enjoy those things. We fight even now. We enjoy. We work together. We want to be stayed together. And that is something which I strongly look at. My sons are going to miss out those things.
Yes, exactly.
Because that we have enjoyed.
And
that is something which has given us a insightful of everybody. Is it a competition among? Of course, there was a competition, but same time we were all enjoying it.
Yeah, that's what I said. Like, in it's an affectionate situation, We fight and we are brothers at the end of the day.
We enjoy.
Yes. So that's where we learn to build ourselves stronger.
Exactly. Yeah. When we understand, see, that is something which is going to be help us, especially when you are in a joint family kind of situation. The one of the benefit is we understand the situation without even somebody expressing it to us.
Yeah, exactly.
We can feel and we can understand, we can adjust.
Yes.
We can mold ourselves to the kind of a situation. These are the things which you will not learn in the school.
No, no school can teach this. Yeah. It's purely experimental. It's all about experiencing things, who likes what, who dislikes what, how to manage things. How to get more sweets.
No, those are the real
yeah.
challenges. Because the most important, I still remember one of the critical, we were all supposed to go to national or state jamborees.
Yeah.
In my state jamboree in 8th standard when I was, I had my elder cousin who was also with us and my sister, elder sister. We were all three going in it from a different school. We were participating in the same jamboree.
Okay.
And the most important is my mother, she said, okay, anyway, you are going there for 8 days. And she decided to give us around 20 code bread.
Okay.
For each one of us.
Okay.
And she kept it in the three different boxes. And we said, on the day, we are supposed to take and go. So I used to steal code bread from my cousin's dabba. And she, my sister, used to pick up the code bread from my dabba. So that's how the most important, when my mother, the day she was packing up, absolutely there is no code bread in none of the dabba.
So exactly.
These are the kind of thinking which we have enjoyed, and these are the kind of harmony also, because we were not fought, we were all enjoyed.
Yeah.
We were all enjoyed. Okay. This is the kind of thing we have all enjoyed. I think probably I see that for everybody, the kind of life which somebody go through in the childhood is going to be the real amazing.
Yes.
That is a true life, true world, no filter.
Mm.
We fight, we love each other, and we go together. Probably, I think that was a kind of natural life which we had. No artificial content.
Yeah.
Nothing.
That also teaches after the fight, we will be still friends.
Right.
Yeah. Absolutely. So now, if we don't grow up with that, fight means the end.
I always say that your last mistakes may be the end. So there, it's okay.
Yeah.
That mistake is to stay there for 5 minutes, 10 minutes.
That's it. We learn to forget it.
We have to go in the same cycle.
Yeah.
We go for the same cricket, same sports.
And how did you come to Mysore? What made you?
See, truth is, as I said, my academic, I was very, very strong. I did a diploma in electronics and communication. And after my diploma, I lost my father when I was in second year diploma.
Mm-hmm.
So naturally, we have to quit all the amenities and facilities we had. And honestly speaking, that was my turning point. Because that, as an elder son, everybody started telling me that, you are an elder son, you have to take responsibility.
Yeah.
I was not aware about it, nothing. Then I relocated to Shivamogga. Then I completed my education. I went to Bangalore for applying for jobs.
Mm-hmm.
So I was at the kind of an impression after my diploma in electronics and communication, completing it. It was in 88. If I go to Bangalore, naturally, Narayan Murthy or Premji would have been waiting for me in Majestic to pick me up. That was the impression which I had. So then when I went to Bangalore, then I realized, because I am from Kannada medium. And then I realized that, I was from the category of apply, no reply.
Yeah.
So typically call it as yellusalladava.com. So after 3 months, when I exhausted my all cash, everything in Bangalore, then I realized, okay, I'm not going to get anywhere in Bangalore. So I was purely searching for a job because I need to feed back the home,
family.
And my mother used to ask me, so what next? So there are certain two things which have helped me a lot, two questions in my life. What next? And what do you want to be? So these are the two questions even now, which bothers me a lot. So then after that, one of my uncle, he said, why don't you come to Mysore? So that I decided to come to Mysore. So that at least staying, food, was everything taken is care. Pre-lodging food.
Yes, yes.
So I came to Mysore. I started my journey. In fact, I was also honestly frustrated, not getting the job. And then I got into one of the small company called the Mercury Instrument and Chemicals.
Mm-hmm.
It was in Siddhappa Road.
Siddhappa Square?
Near Siddhappa Square.
Mm-hmm.
So I got into that. There was, we were all selling chemicals and surgical instruments.
Mm-hmm.
So I was joined that company, that shop.
Yes, yes.
We used to call them as a company to promote ourselves. So I joined as a office boy. I was a delivery boy. My first journey was my 200 rupees was my salary.
Mm.
And that is how my journey has started, honestly. And so that's how my career, because I got some job.
Yes, yes.
To demonstrate that. In fact, believe me or not, I got my visiting card done on that particular day to show to the external world, saying that I'm a marketing executive. I only paid it and got it done for a 25 rupees, 20, 50 visiting
cards.
So yeah. I just wanted to demonstrate I'm not an office boy. Nobody was asking me, but you know, I wanted to be promoted myself. But I started as a delivery boy because I used to tell, I used to get 10 rupees per day and for my bus travel. So I used to save at least 7 rupees in out of that. So that's how my humble beginning has.
So from there, how did you come into computer world, like educating people?
See, I was little know about electronics and communication, not much. Then I was delivery boy. Then I felt that, you know, again, my two questions, what next and what I want to be. I used to feel that I'm not going to be staying office boy forever.
Yes.
Then after 3 months or 4 months, then I quit that job. Then I started looking out for a job. Then I got a job in Bangalore as a service engineer because I did my electronics and communication. So there they asked me, can you get trained for a further? So for me, anywhere is okay.
Yeah.
So then I went to Bangalore. I worked for 15 days and I said, okay, why don't you go to Bombay and get trained? So I went to Bombay and got it trained. I was there for 6 months without even understanding Hindi one line. So I was there. Then I learned a couple of things, especially little bit of electronics and all that I have learned. So servicing and everything. So that's how I started. But I enjoyed their teaching. And that's how my you know, instinct has started working towards learning and all that. Because there, I was forced to learn. But at the same time, I started enjoying learning. And that was real learning I started. Then after that, I was back to Bangalore. Then I worked. Then I started working in Mysore. So I worked for 1 year. But my inclination towards education was a bit more because I used to go and install computers in different places.
Uh-huh.
At that time, there's a lot of computer training used to be takes place in different schools.
Yes,
so
yes,
we used to carry the computer, install it. After the training, we used to pick up and bring it back.
Mm-hmm.
Next day, some other school. Next day, some other school. And I was an extra player for a train as a trainer. Because if one person is absent, so naturally,
you have to,
so we need to teach.
Yeah.
And I used to know only, you know, I know about only hardware, how it works and all that. So I used to teach, I used to show them. Started enjoying that. That's how I started. Then after I left that organization, then finally I said, okay, why don't I start myself? It was in 1991, November 12th, I decided. And they said, I asked my mother, I wanted to start. And she said, fine, if you really want to start, you can start, because she was okay with it. Then November 13th, I started in half of the car shed of my one of my customer's place. They gave me that. So that time, no investment. Literally, I had 1 rupee 20 paisa in my pocket. I still remember. And that is how I started my beginning. And they started. I used to get a computer from Gokulam. Shashidhar Prasad was my friend. Shashi, he used to give me a computer. I used to bring that computer in my Luna, teach them during the lunch hours for 1 hour, 15 minutes, and go and give it back to the computers every day.
Wow.
And that is how I started my journey of teaching. So I need to give a name to the company. So then I decided, okay, my father name was, the nickname is called as a Ramana. So that's how R-A-M-A-N-A, I just removed A, so I made it as a Raman and Computers. So Raman Computers, journey I started in 1991,
November
13th. So
wow.
Completing 30 years of that.
My God.
So I started a small summer camp training. Then I got into some more larger, so that I brought another, bought 3-4 computers extra. So then I started, then I moved to the bigger premises in Mysore Ballar complex. Then from there, we have opened up roughly around 30 training institutions in Karnataka.
My God.
And I had my office in Bangalore, we had a 5 centers. Every district I had my center, and that's how the training has started.
Wow.
And that time, well, less known for computers.
In yeah.
Very less. But that was a good opportunity, and that's how I.
More than the opportunity, you were ready to invest yourself.
Because that is the only thing which I had.
Yes.
Honestly. Because.
No, you could have stayed as a delivery boy.
True.
Yeah. But I want to bring your attention to one thing which is very interesting for me. You said you went to Bombay for training. And yes, the education part, learning part was good. But living in Bombay without full language, without that tools, survival tools, as
basic language
of either English or Marathi, Hindi, any of that. That survival is the most important. Can you say a few things, sir, about how did you manage that?
See, one is, I always look back, and this is one thing. Sometimes, I tell my students many a times, being poor is a blessing.
Yes.
Honestly, it is.
Yes, definitely. I agree with that. Yeah.
And why? Because I had not even a single second thought about or a luxury or language, anything. I was waiting for any opportunities.
Yeah.
That is one. So I was very clear about I'm going to Bombay, and for me it was a pride for
yes.
going to Bombay. One is language, second one is food.
Yeah.
Because it's a tough call. And third, I have to survive with what money I have, and I have to send certain money back to my mom. And that is also one more. So for me, I took it as lot of learning. Honestly, it was lot of learning. For
yes.
me, it is exposure, learning
yes.
something new.
Completely new.
Completely new. I still remember, even though I came from Bhadravati to Mysore, 88. I saw the big circle, Ramaswamy circle. I was shocked. My cousin has given me the cycle. I was stopped my cycle in Ramaswamy circle because it was a 5-lakh. So I don't know how to cross that such a big circle. I never seen such a big circle in Bhadravati, honestly speaking.
Yeah, yeah.
So for me, that everything was new. It looks very silly today, but that was the fact.
True, that's all, yeah.
Less exposure, not known language. We don't know. The truth is, I was not even heard about this called the Vice Chancellor. Not even know about there is President of India or Deputy Commissioner. We are such a... ignorant or innocent.
That's yeah, innocent because it was not there.
We were very focused towards cricket, nothing more than that, to weekend cricket.
Yes. Yeah.
And that's how it is. But Bombay gave me the real life, what is life is all about.
Yeah.
Life is all about. How do you cope up with that life? How do you cope up with the speed?
Yes.
Especially moving in the train. The train taught me many
that's
many
the
lessons,
thing.
Many, many lessons.
Yeah.
How quick one should be.
Okay. Because Bombay is, the way I have seen it is like, if you sit down and cry, nobody will come and ask you.
It's a waste of time.
Yeah. It's like, you have to get up and wipe your tears and move.
And it keeps you in a consciousness more.
Yeah.
You know why? Because I want to see that, you know, when is my next stop? Which is my next stop?
Yep.
And
yep.
it has taught me that, how do I read that every Hindi line?
Yes.
I need to remember the numbers. I need to pick up those. I need to memorize the route.
Yeah.
Because my language problem. I don't know they call it as 25 or 15 or 50. That is something which is number.
Yes.
And this is which really gave me a kind of, probably I was not even thought these are the kind of a challenges. I said these are the things I need to learn.
These are all the survival things. Yeah.
Tools.
Yes.
So I need to work on it. And that's how I got into that and learned. Pav Bhaji, I've adjusted to Pav Bhaji.
You have to.
So it's simple.
You can't get your curd rice there.
Absolutely. I cannot demand anything.
Yeah.
And sometimes if there is no cash, and water is a resource. So that's
yep.
how you need to be. And probably, honestly speaking, because of that, again, I've come from a small town that has helped me to live in a bigger town.
Yeah. Because living in a small town, living in a large family, you learn to adapt.
Right.
Yeah.
Fast adapt.
Yes. And being poor is another, it's if you are ready for challenges, being poor is a blessing.
So why that blessing? Let me tell you, because it may be very, very useful to many. When you have a huge resources, your mind naturally does not work with all the small components. When you have a less resource and you want to deliver certain things, a big, then your optimal utilization of the resource works.
Yes, yes,
you will start using your mind for optimal utilization of the resource. That is something which is very, very big.
Yeah.
So probably this being poor has helped me to bring the optimal utilization of every opportunity. Second is being humble.
Yeah.
Because you have to be. There is no other way. So being humble. And these are the things which have...
And you cannot waste things.
You can't.
Because you have no second chance there. You cannot...
Absolutely no second chance.
So you, with whatever you have to make the most out of it. So these are all the things that... life gives you an opportunity.
See, this is where exactly this life skills I started acquiring.
Yeah.
Living skill, life skill, acquiring it. I started understanding between the life standard versus living standards.
Mm-hmm.
So these are the things which I've learned. So today, you know, whatever that, how to stay grounded. Probably Bombay standard.
Yeah. That's the best part. Yeah. Now, having established 30 plus centers all over Karnataka, and you must be having like thousands of students learning. Now, how are the modern day students coping up with all this information overload, confusion? How do you see that?
I'll pick up a two question out of that. Right?
Yes.
One is... that was a hype of IT.
Yes.
When I started.
Yeah.
I, God blessing, I got into this track of IT. That also helped me because, you know, the kind of, we started working on it. There, I tried my best to give the best out of it at the low cost. Because that helped me to figure out what costing I'm supposed to keep. I always go back, whenever I used to fix the fee, I used to think about myself in Bhadravati. Can that Venkatesh can afford it?
Yeah.
I always go back. Can they able to do that? Okay. And again, when I see that, you know, entire Bhadravati used to come to me in my mind when I fix anything, any curriculum, how do I teach? How do I reach? How I can create my class much more interesting?
Mm-hmm.
And how do we make this activity driven?
Yes.
This is what it is. So that is the part which I have learned. So second is, coming back to your question, is here that student, I strongly look at that one of the biggest advantages of student, we can definitely mold them how we want.
Mm.
It is honestly depending upon how confidently we pick up those kids, our candidate.
Mm-hmm.
I always tell that before you teach them, love them.
Yeah. Yeah.
That changes. If you start loving them, and I want to be very, very straightforward. If I say a particular person, what you are doing is wrong, it is wrong. It's okay. He may feel bad for 1 minute or 2 minutes or 2 days. It's okay. But he start realizing why I said. I don't want to play my artificial thinking that, okay, you know, why should I worry about that kid or anything. I should be genuine. So ensure that I always ensure that my intent should be good when I say something.
Actually, that was my... Almost I was reaching that question, because to have this many students, children all over, and to teach them, I was just thinking that you spoke exactly that. Without loving them, there is no way you can reach.
It will become artificial.
Yeah, you have
you
to
don't
have
enjoy. It. I am going to lose my life.
You are going to lose your life, then it becomes stressful.
It
and
become more about commercial.
You will have to drag yourself without half-heartedly. So, you should be having a huge heart in that way.
No, that's like, the big advantages which I had. I'll tell you honestly. I had a chamber, but I used to sit anywhere I want. I was comfortable with my students. I used to enjoy my time. And I started... See, the most important is, I don't want to be sit in the... Sorry, I may use a wrong word. Called as a cage.
Yeah.
So you may call it a chamber, we may call it as a chamber, but I call it as a cage. Because normally there are only two locations you can see that. One is in zoo, you can find the cage. And one is, unfortunately, in a government office, we will see the higher officers will be in the cage. That's a very sad part of it. See, if I want to enjoy my life, I have to be part of my, with my kids.
Hmm.
Okay, and that is where exactly, because I come again, I'll go back to Bhadravati because I've connected back, because that's how I enjoyed my life. I've enjoyed my life. And we used to call them, even my students by their nickname, enjoying them, talking to them, working towards it. I used to give the 100% key of my office to my kids and they used to, you know, use this for night. I was never even thought of that they are going to steal anything. I used to take it in a positive spirit because there is security inside.
Yeah. And they would honor it.
Yes.
Yeah.
And that's how I've enjoyed it. And honestly, that's how I've enjoyed it. And I see that is one of the most important is when I see that when I, my intent is ready, intent is God, I don't need to worry about too much.
Yes.
Not even worry about your words, not even worry about your tone.
Yeah.
When your intent is right. Because my kids need to be pick up the real intent behind that word and the tone rather than just word.
What the meaning, the what he said, why he said, nothing like that. Because it communicates strongly than the meaning of the word, what you say.
See, many of the boys or girls, they used to come and tell their own personal issues, talk to me. I used to ensure that I never leak that data to anybody, including in my family.
Yeah.
And protect whatever it is. Because the intent is not to share about A or B. My intent was to ensure that he can able to come out of that pain. Because I have come through the same storyline. And that is what actually, I'll tell you that, you know, how I can, you know, life skills I used to incorporate in my education. That's how it is. So it's beyond, even now, today, in fact, incidentally, Geeta Srinath, she has messaged me. She is my 2011 kid. And she messaged me that more than a 6 months of IT learning, you taught me life leading and life learning.
Wow.
Okay. And I said, good, go move on. And that's how it is. So can we teach more than that? So I'm preparing my kids for living skill or life skill. Right? So I'm not interested to only to make that job readiness, not industry readiness. I want to make sure that they're life readiness.
That's the most important thing we need.
That's critical.
Yeah. Because like job readiness, yes, they can make money, but they may know how to use that money valuably. It may not be possible. So how do you bring that life readiness in the
curriculum?
Yeah, in the curriculum, in the syllabus or in your teachings.
So that is the best part of it I enjoy. Because I do the experience learning and experience teaching. I've learned from the experience. I'll go back and quote, in a scout, I have learned a lot many things. Because, you know, flag hoisting, many things which we had. And all this, I was managed, I was to understand. I understand, okay, out of 8 members, one guy not be able to contribute more. One guy can contribute a bit more. So that we used to understand very simple, and we never used to feel that he is poor, he is rich. They're all of my teammates. That is one part of it. So again, I picked up, copied my, you know, story from a scout and guide. That's all. So what I do is, now when I run a finishing school right now, I look at there are only 5 skills which every kid should learn. That is for job readiness.
Yeah.
Or industry readiness. Job readiness is just for example, if I know how to pick up, how to put my, fix the puncture, right? If I know how to fix the puncture, that's a job readiness.
Yeah.
If I know how to fix the cycle completely, that is industry readiness.
Industry readiness, yeah.
Now, what is the life readiness? I think the most important is assumption for a minute. Now, tubeless tires comes into your picture. If I'm a job ready, I'm going to lose the job.
Yeah.
And if the industry itself is going to be collapsed, then how do I do it? Then there's a big question, that life readiness. So I always look at, I educate my kids to become a life readiness. Don't get shocked. Don't get worried when you lose the jobs. First thing is, I said, if you lose a job, simple, come back to me. That's what. Giving them a kind of a confidence.
Yes, yes.
And pushing them a little more courage. That is what it is. So I used to give them a kind of an experience in that. The one small example I can give you is very simple, that as soon as my kids, they report on the day, the first weekend, I used to take them for a trekking to Chamundi Hill. Whenever we go, and the most important is all my staff and students has to be part of it.
Yeah.
We used to climb up and maybe by 200, 400 steps, my kids used to realize their life about Kurkure, less effectiveness of all the life. Then they started realizing, I used to teach at the 400 steps or 500 steps, impact of Kurkures.
Yeah.
I used to tell them why you are supposed to have a healthy food.
Mm-hmm.
Give them that. Don't teach them, because the most important is, I tell you the most important is, will you get fear yourself for the ghost? I say no, in the daytime. So now similarly, what I say to every kid is very simple. If you can teach them on the 500 steps, then they realize the importance of the healthy food.
Yeah, it was in.
Okay. And the most important is, most of my kids, they used to be always crib that, okay, they're poor, they come from the backward family, economically poor. So I used to take them to, there is one called the Ramanna School, just above the Chamundi. And they're all kids are there. And they're all come from the anath ashram.
Mm-hmm.
So these kids, I used to tell them that, you know, see, look at these kids. They're so happy. They're enjoying it. They're loving it. So don't trip on the same story.
Mm.
You're far, far better than those kids. So experiential learning again.
Yeah.
These stories, I used to tell them, no more discussion that you are from poor family, you're from a village, I'm from Kannada medium. This story will not work. So, same time, I used to give them a other contrary. I used to take them to the bigger industries.
Mm-hmm.
Ask them to think big. This is how the industry is thinking about it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So, connect these two gaps. How you can able to connect.
Yeah.
And that's how I used to build them on that. And most of that soft skill training, I used to take them to Rangayana and for the drama. They have to play a drama of 10, 15 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
So, again, come back. And most of my kids, they come from Kannada medium. So
yeah.
I used to make them, request them to play 5 to 10 minutes of drama in English.
English.
So that, you know, basically to, you know, push them up. And that's what we used to do, is called experience learning. Wow. So this is what I strongly look at. We were different. And this is something which helped my kids effectively. And that's how we work. And if they are not well, anybody, we used to take them, anybody in our campus, somebody should take my kids to. Because 99% of my kids used to be come from, in a finishing school, they used to be come from different districts.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah.
So they used to stay alone. So we used to take care of their health and all that. So just to treat them a little bit, inform their parents, she's okay or he's okay. So that made them to bind effectively, which helped them. And we worked together, and these are the kind of experiential learning we have started incorporating as a part of a life skill.
Yes, yes, yes.
How you?
That's the one very, very beautiful thing you said, taking them to the very low school, kids are from the orphanage, and taking them to the very big industry. Two extreme points. You can be here, but you can be there.
Exactly. Exactly. You may born as there,
yeah,
but you can lead that.
You can definitely reach there. It's only thing is like your choice. Do you want to sit down and cry? Or do you want to stand up and dust yourself off and walk? So, if they make up their mind, I want to reach there, they can find.
It is only a ignite.
Yes.
They need that spark.
Yeah.
So, my job was only to ignite these kids.
It's such an amazing thing. Like.
Yeah. And for me, that is to take around 5 to 6 months, but I need to ignite. Because for me, I was looking out for a consistency of this ignite is critically factor.
Yeah, yeah,
once
yeah.
they leave my campus.
Yeah, yeah. Because it's not just you can just throw fire on them. You have to wait for it, right time, right situation, time. Right condition. So all of that has to be considered.
So you have to create that amount of environment,
yeah.
love, affection.
Yes.
More important is you have to build a trust.
Trust there.
Trust. Yeah. So there are many, many, many components which
yes.
is there. And you should also have that those kids can able to come and share with me.
Yes.
Try to create that kind of... environment.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's amazing.
So, of course, more or less predominantly, they used to come and talk to me.
Mm-hmm. So, now looking back, you have, there should be quite a bit of satisfaction, quite a bit of sense of like achievement, in the sense, I don't want to use the word achievement, I would say what I wish I had in my childhood, I am providing it to these children. Now, what next for you? What, where do you want to go from here?
So, good thing you brought the question is, now, whatever I studied in the 17 years in Bhadravati, for me, all my neighbors, my school teachers, my relatives, used to teach us only life skills.
Yeah.
That is what I used to teach here.
Yeah.
Simple. So, yeah. I'm not missing anything from Bhadravati, or I feel bad about it. It's, I really enjoy it, because those are the things which I'm bringing it here. That is one. So, now what next is the is scale and the speed and the using the kind of technology which is available, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, today our discussion can go anywhere because of the YouTube technology.
Yes, yes.
So, how do I make that? So, that is where exactly which I am seriously working on, right? But on a passion.
Yeah.
So, I want to set a new measurement unit of measuring a person.
Okay,
that is very nice. Is it measured by economics? You said you don't want to use success story or
achievement.
Achievement.
Yeah.
I want to look at the accomplishment.
Yeah.
Okay. How one can accomplish.
Mm-hmm.
I always tell everybody that you need to leave your footmark and go. What is the footmark you are going to leave is very, very simple.
Yes.
Probably I use this opportunity and your channel to tell. This is something which is, honestly, you know, embedded in my mind. I have not seen a single statue in India, because I traveled across India and 8 different countries. I have not seen somebody who was so rich, that's why his statue is there. So, I have seen the statue who is writers,
yes,
poets, people who are accomplished.
Yeah.
You can find the statues.
Yeah.
They left their footmark.
Yes.
And that is where exactly I look at. If you follow Saraswati, Lakshmi follows you.
Yeah.
That is what I strongly believe in that. So, what is that I wanted to reach is, now, how do I reach a more number?
Mm-hmm.
More rural. Because I always go back to my rural. So, that's the kind of…
Yeah.
In fact, 90… I have trained, if I'm not wrong, maybe 50,000 people, students have reached till so far. 99% is my rural kids. 98% at least have reached rural kids. And that is all, 30 years of my journey, and that's all. So, how do I scale it?
Yeah.
So, I see now the limitation and the industry side, I need to balance it out. And now, I am bringing out the concept called as a profile. How do I make it proof with file? It's called as a profile.
Yeah.
So, I want to bring the profile wherein I want every individual to share their passion. I strongly look at and believe that every student or every person, every individual has a story to tell and passion to share.
Yes, definitely. Yeah.
So, I want them to use this opportunity and build their portfolio strong. And I want them to be happy and pride and proud.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm not addressing their pain. I'm addressing their pride.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. And because I know every kid's, every person
has a story. Yes, yes.
Only thing is, they have not got the opportunity to share it. So, I want to create a platform for them to share their feel.
Yes.
And that's how I am trying to do it. And naturally, what happens is, if I am a good friend of you, I definitely show it to you. And how I have built my portfolio, it will definitely ignite you.
Okay.
If I have done good, it will ignite you. You always want to have a healthy competitive competition.
True. Yeah, yeah. And also, so inspiring.
Naturally, it's going to be inspiring. So, that's why we said profile.in is more about passion ignites.
Mm-hmm.
So, that's how.
So, you are creating an app so that…
We have created an app. We have around 25 test run we have done. 25,000 individuals they have started using.
Oh, really? Wow.
Yes. Around 1,384 companies have started accessing it.
Oh, really? That's wonderful.
And around… almost 1,900 institutions has boarded now. This is, we have done with the testing. So, I'm sure we need to scale it up across India right now. Then we wanted to go outside India. Objective is, how I can able to connect a small village boy to his passion world in Germany. And that's how I'm thinking about it.
Yeah.
Most of the social media, normally what happens, we follow a person. Suppose if I say the A person, he is an entrepreneur, naturally I follow A person.
Yeah.
I will also oversee his personal life.
Mm-hmm.
Because he starts sharing in his page, in the social media. Naturally, what happens is when I'm following up, so we lose the passion track and we get into the more about the personal life of the particular person whom we follow. But we have created an app in the profile.in, which follow a passion than a person.
Mm.
So if I am a journalist, I can follow the group of journalism content,
yeah,
not about the journalist.
Yes, yes. Yeah.
And that's how we have made, and that's how we are trying to bring in. So we are connecting people across globe for similar passion.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So that's how we are bringing this new platform.
So that will be made, everybody put their stories there in that. Whatever I want to express myself as.
Whatever your passion is.
Yeah.
We restricted for their personal content.
Yeah, yeah.
But the passion, if they have something.
Yes.
Anything which is learning.
Yes.
See, let's realistically today, if you look at, you know, we used to say TV serials are not good and it's not value adding anything. Now, what is that we are doing it in? We are blaming TV, but we are getting into Facebook.
Yes.
Again, we are following the junk.
Same
that thing. Part of the today world is we follow a junk content, junk debate, junk food.
Mm-hmm.
Then where do you expect the healthy
outcome.
Debate, a healthy outcome and healthy body and mind?
Yeah.
So this, can I able to ignite some of them using this platform?
Yes.
That's the objective which I'm trying to
do. Okay. That's such a wonderful object for a younger generation. You were talking something about learning and unlearning. Can you elaborate a little on that part?
Sure. See, today we are all talking about learning. See, there is today in education system, the biggest issue is, probably I'll try and touch upon even on an NEP, which is a very, very good initiative, so that it will be a very, very useful. Learning is happening. And I'll just give you one of the typical example of everybody, how the education system till so far we are running. We give an example of you have a jar and we say that, okay, put the stone. And now then we say, okay, is the jar is filled? You say,
yes, full.
Then we say, I'll put small marbles.
Mm-hmm.
Then again, it can accommodate so many. Then we said, okay. See, jar, you said it was
full,
but now I am saying still it is taken. That's how your mind is all about. Another one more example is that then we put a sand.
Mm-hmm.
Still it is able to consume so much of sand. Then said now it's full. Yes, it's full. Then we pour the water. This is the example we have been given.
Mm-hmm.
This is where exactly I want my kids to be under. What is the under? Why do you fill the stone first?
Hmm.
Why? Start with the why. If it is not useful, then why are you filling it? Unnecessary, we are fading it and making our memory full. What is the purpose of life or purpose of learning? Today, the NEP should not become a policy, it should be a purpose. If you make a NEP, new education policy, as a purpose, we win.
Yes.
If you make it as a policy, then again, you have to cover 8 hours of class, take the attendance, take this 75% of the attendance and go. That is policy.
Mm-hmm.
It defeats the purpose. Now, here what I want to say that we need to unlearn. Who has to unlearn?
Hmm.
That is something which is very, very important. Is the kid has to be unlearned? No.
No.
Because kid had to learn.
Yes.
I think that people who are all trainers and teachers must unlearn. What is that unlearn? Unwanted things, unnecessary things, don't feed to anybody. Don't even feed to yourself. Look at the today world. We're talking about communication skill. What is the communication skill? That, you know, suppose I communicate to you. Bigger than that, there is a two communication skill.
Hmm.
What is that communication is? One is external communication, one is internal communication.
Hmm.
If I start treating that internal communication, you are bad, you are bad, you are bad, I am going to leave that impression you are bad.
Yeah.
It is an internal communication. So internal communication is more dangerous than that external communication. So what I need to rework on is my internal communication first. What is that I communicate to myself?
Yes.
About a person, place, things, animals, books, anything.
Yes.
That is very, very critical. So what I need to do is I need to unlearn. I have to prioritize. Is this ABCD component is required? My humble request to people who are all watching this. Please don't feed yourself the data which is not worth, and don't feed any junk data. This is, it kills you.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. If I use certain word on you, because that word is already stored in me.
Yeah, yeah.
So I think, why should I store those words? Right? So I think this I need to unlearn. I need to unlearn. I need to start feeding. There is one, I always tell you that do right things or store right things.
Mm-hmm.
If you store right things.
Yes.
Do right things is a default.
Yes, it's automatically happens.
Right?
Yeah.
So do things right. Are right things do.
Yes.
So I think if we can start working towards doing right things, all the problem can be solved.
Mm-hmm.
So unlearn is basically I am trying to bring that I can't unlearn it, I can.
Yes.
If not, who can?
Mm-hmm.
There is one quote, if you can, you can.
Yeah.
If you can't, you can't. I have changed that quote. If you can, you can. If you can't, you can't.
Want.
I've just changed it into, if you can, you can. If you can't, who can?
Mm-hmm.
When you can't, then nobody can.
Nobody can, yes.
So that is where exactly I'm trying to bring in the kind of a unlearn.
Okay.
Unlearn, relax. Keep your mind lighter. Lighter.
Yes.
That helps you set that direction. That today, very, very, I call it as a 6D approach for anybody to succeed in their path which they are into. Maybe a farmer to anybody, even for a politician or engineer or anybody. So the most important is everybody has been measured by the delivery. What is it he delivers?
Yeah.
For that, you require a dedication and determination. So D, D, D.
Yeah.
Dedication, determination.
Delivery.
And delivery. This is one. But most important, this is what's being taught to us.
Mm.
You should be dedicated, determination, then
you can deliver. Yeah.
That's all. The delivery is the, you know, the
end point. Yeah, end point. Yeah.
But what we are missing out the component is, what we need to unlearn and work on it. Is it not important, these 3D? It is important. But the more important is, do I have a dream?
Mm-hmm.
Once you have the dream, set the direction.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you need to have dream and direction, then the discipline.
Yes.
These three components are a very, very three important D. Then you get into dedication, determination. And
so
I think this is what you need to work.
If you can take care of the of these three D's, dreaming,
direction,
discipline. So if you can manage these three.
You can win the world.
You can... Yeah, you can be wherever you want to be.
Very, very.
You can deliver.
Everybody thinking about speed make them success. Sorry.
Mm-hmm.
Direction makes. Mm. Because if you are running in the wrong direction, you never end.
You will end up in the wrong place.
The biggest problem of the today youth is, are we setting them a right direction? If you set the direction, even if he walks too slow,
no.
But he's towards his goal.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. We all know that by that story of tortoise and the hare.
True.
So space is not the most important. Going in the right direction is the...
So what we need to do today is, there are people who are already filled with too many things. Make them to unlearn certain things which is not wanted.
Yes, yes.
And disconnect from all unwanted things so that you have... You may call it as a limited content, I call it as a focused content. Pick up those things. Start working on it, live happy.
Yeah, what more I want? Creating too much junk and becoming very popular or rich or something and completely unhappy, or stay within the very focused limit and then
enjoy
your life and be happy.
Enjoy.
So,
and the most important is, the world is right now for me, honestly, very, very peaceful.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because I don't watch any news.
That's a good choice. It's
really, I see that world is in peaceful and very, very harmony.
Yeah.
So I don't watch any New Zealand, I'm happy.
Because this is where you have the sea all green and everything is
comfortable.
Beautiful.
You have to be. And when you are happy internally, you see everybody happy.
Exactly. Because you haven't created already a program that is bad, this is bad, that country is bad, this person is bad. You keep it clean and
this
learning.
Wherever I go to my students or anybody, whomever I meet, my relatives or friends, I tell them very simple. Please don't speak about a person who is not there in that meeting. Because why do you speak about others when you don't have content on yourself?
Yes.
Speak content which really matters.
Yes, yes.
Which helps others. Otherwise, shut mouth.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So that's how it is.
That's more damaging.
True. Because when you open your mouth, the world will come to know who you are.
Exactly. True.
So I think whatever that little you know.
Wow, that's so important. That's very, very important. Absolutely. Yeah. What are we doing with time? Yeah.
5 minutes.
5 more minutes. Okay. You give us time and we will go for it, no problem. With all these processes, what you are doing, do you get any support from outside, external agencies, or maybe from the government, recognition?
Beautiful question. See. Again, I'll go back to the same old story of
Bhadravati.
If your intent is good, you get support.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody thinks nobody support. Trust me, today, whatever I am, it is only by the support which is external, including government.
Mm-hmm.
I can boldly tell in front of your television, I have not paid single bribe till so far. I have done a lot of government works.
Mm-hmm.
My friends, my alumni, my students, my family, my relatives, everybody stood with me. It is not just I am just one face of it.
Mm-hmm.
I may call myself as a, you know, I love to call them as a representative of all these people for this particular object.
Yeah.
Not even a leader.
Yeah.
The most important is, it has so happened to me when I spoke to, in 2002, I wanted to do a MysoreIT.com. We did that completely. My friends were there together. We were all. We were not even know how to invite anybody, and we went and approached Chief Minister. We were very clear. We had a dream to invite President of India for Mysore. We never thought this is big. Our aspiration is very simple because we are inspired with Abdul Kalamji. We wanted to call him Abdul Kalamji. Simple, is that simple? But when I went, it was so surprised. And the most important that time, S.M. Krishna was Chief Minister. He said, "Young boys are doing it. Why should I say no? Go ahead. I'll give you a letter." So people are supported. If your intent is good, our intent is not to make money. Our intent is not to build a brand for ourselves. Our intent is, can I show this exhibition to the thousands youth, 1,000 government school kids? It works. It works. Many people who supported me, many bureaucrats supported me, many people still, they, you know, this is what we have done. Recently, I did a one more program called Skill on Wheels for the Government of India. Mm-hmm. We have reached around 2.74 lakhs youths.
Wow.
And everybody have encouraged, everybody, and they want it. So that is the kind of thing. Again, coming back to the same square, keep your intent right. You get definitely 100% support. We have a good people, bad people, both. If your intent is good, you will attract
the good one.
If your intent is bad, you attract the wrong people. That's it.
Yes. Yes. That's so wonderful. So with this support and all the government, friends, everything, any recognition that you can tell our viewers that, because that's also matters, because it's not just your achievements or your things, it's the whole team has been recognized, acknowledgements.
Acknowledgement wise, good, but I don't call it as a reward or award because everybody are a part of it.
Yeah.
In fact, yesterday I got an award for Dr. Balasubramanian award, not as a singer, because they are first time they introduced this for different sectors.
Education.
On a skill development.
Yeah.
That is how S.M. Krishna ji has given me that.
Mm-hmm.
That is one. And I was also been awarded as Dare to Dream Award from Z Business.
That's a very important, the name itself is very exciting.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Really exciting. And So, Corporate Citizen Award from Chamber of Commerce. So, a couple of that which we got. And this is all something which gives me a more
motivation. Yeah, responsibility, motivation, and also expectations.
I always love to give something new.
Yeah.
I want to always explore it. Not because I want my kids to be enjoy, I want to enjoy first.
Yes.
I'm selfish.
No, no, that's
how. Why I'm selfish is very simple, because all my, somebody call them as alumni, somebody call them as students, I call them as my kids, so I enjoy. So that, you know.
It's a family affair.
Yes. If I go to Bangalore, I get at least 10,000 kids to meet.
Wow. So
because predominantly many are there. And at least around 5 to 7% of my kids, they're all overseas right now. They're all studying there. And they're all continuing their career.
Seeing that prosperity makes you feel like so contented.
Honestly, I have not thought of it. Honestly.
Yes.
Because for me, that was my entertainment.
Mm-hmm.
And I always tell my students that EEE is a concept which I follow.
Mm-hmm.
EEE. One E is everybody should have should continuous education.
Yeah.
Second one is earning.
Mm-hmm.
Third one is entertainment. So you can allocate 6 hours, 6 hours, 6 hours, and another 6 hours for sleeping.
Yeah.
So at least, so 18 hours, you have to split into three pieces. So education, 6 hours. 6 hours of
earning,
you know, earning, and
entertainment.
For me, 18 hours
is just E.
All
E entertainment.
For me, education happens through my kids, and 18 hours my entertainment, and my earning also come from them.
Yeah. So it's
so what a bliss.
All three into one.
18 hours a day I spend on all the three.
Yes.
And that is something which is very, very good.
Wonderful. It's been such a unlearning, educating, wonderful time for me to talk to you. And thank you so much for giving this opportunity to sit with you and listen to you. It's a really honor.
No, thank you. My privilege, honestly.
Thank you very much.
To share whatever the little I know. And if this is going to be useful to the everybody and anybody, I just wanted to leave with everybody one thought. Don't put yourself down because you are from poor family background, or from village, or from Kannada medium, or any local language. So, opportunity God has given, everybody is the same. Only thing is, you have to see it, and you have to capture it, and you have to move on. Be more focused, move towards your, first, please understand your dream, set direction. Without discipline, you cannot achieve anything.
Yes.
I think these three things, you have to start seriously work on it. Then your determination, dedication, whatever. I think this is what it is going to be happening. So I wish every viewers to be accomplishment in their life.
Yeah.
With doing something to their nation,
yeah,
to the world. That's one. And again, I'm so thankful to you and your team for giving me this wonderful opportunity to share.
We are very happy.
And I request you to continue this effort, because you are the people who have to take these, reach the unreached.
Yes.
You have to reach the unreached through this mode.
So that's
that
what
can ignite many.
That's what our intention. We have this intent here to reach as many as possible and as you say, ignite them to dare to stand up and keep looking forward. So people like you will definitely help us in this process.
Oh, certainly, yes. I love to do it. I love to be a part of it, because I enjoy
this. This is what we want to do. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yeah.
To see more Inner Journeys, please like, share, and subscribe. Press the bell icon to get notifications.